What is up, guys? Back for another one here. I just got my RS3 plugs in the mail, so I'm about to go out for a drive, warm the engine up a little bit. It is so much easier to remove your coil packs once the engine's hot. I'll go over that for like a quick second whenever I go to do it here, but I just wanted to like tell you guys the differences, I guess. I mean, there really isn't much. It just looks a little bit different. They're supposed to maybe put out a little bit more power, but really, I'm at 59 and some change thousand miles. I think it's time to change coil packs. I'm having a slight misfire at certain spots. I've checked my plugs. Plugs are good. I'm gonna go ahead and check my plugs again today while I'm changing coil packs. Since I'm in there, might as well. But yeah, I figured it was time. It was cheaper to get the RS3 coil packs versus like the regular ones. And from what I understand, the RS3 ones are like an updated part number for the OEM ones or the factory ones, at least for me being a 2016. So there's no crazy modifications or anything. It's literally plug and play. They swap in and out as they should. Yeah, take a lap and then pull these coil packs. Check the plugs, throw the other ones on. I'll show you guys how they look different physically and see if I even notice a difference with the car. I mean, the car idles just fine. It's a cold start. It's sitting right at like 850, 900 RPM. It doesn't really hesitate much at all. I idle on cold start. It does sometimes a little bit, and then I get like a slight hesitation up high, you know, around 5,000 or so more. Sometimes. It's not always. It's not consistent, but yeah. But even since I flashed the new tune, it hasn't done that, so maybe it was because of the new fuel line I had put in. It was being a little weird. I don't know. Either way, it's almost 60,000 miles. It's time to change out the coil packs. Here we are. I'm going to actually wind up keeping these middle two. This one and this one I've swapped around to try and figure out where this misfire is coming from. But I haven't seen it. It hasn't happened since I switched them around. I also updated tunes at like the same time. So I don't know. But I'm going to keep the middle two as backups and then toss out the outside two. Alright, I get asked this question a lot on how to remove the coil pack. So right now you see the grounds are off, okay? That's just the first little top nut that's there. Next up, you're gonna do the connector on each one and then take out the rest of the posts and then pull the plug out. It's easy. You're gonna push down towards you, hit the clip, pull up, and then repeat. Pull down, clip, pull up. Down, clip, pull up, down, clip, pull up, boom. Easy. Now we'll take these off. Once you get your posts out, it's easy. You're just gonna like twist and pull up. Boom. Super duper easy. These two are going in the trash.
So this is about 6,000 miles on the Brisk ER12s. All of them pretty much look like this. Pretty good, holding their gappage as they should be now. Yeah, they all look like that. So I'm happy. I'm gonna plug all these babies back in, torque them down, and then I'll show you guys the difference between the two coil packs. All right. You can see the old one on the left, new one on the right. Slight differences there. Slight differences everywhere, I guess, really. Little different than what I thought it was. Let's see about the hump I was talking about on this one. The back's a little much different, a little bit. The tops. This one just looks cleaner, really. There you go. Let's throw them in.
Now these should just plop right back in. Oh yeah, real nice. Works for me.
All right, they're all in. Didn't give me any trouble. There's no modification required, no nothing. So just pop them on in.
Now, Frank actually just sent me another file. We're trying to get the launch control dialed in just right. So he just sent me another file. So I'm gonna upload that to the car real quick and then go for a drive, see how these feel. Hopefully I'll be able to adjust my launch control on the fly now, and then I can go do some practice launches. We might be doing some racing tonight, so. Well, the car definitely idles a bit smoother. I'm not gonna sit here and say, go spend your money on RS3 coil packs when your coil packs are fine. I'm not sure, like if you were to compare brand new set of the ones that came in the car and a brand new set of RS3s, I'm not sure you'd really see an actual difference. But for me, since mine were old and acting funny, or at least I thought they were, but after going out for this test drive and playing around, Frank actually just made it so I can adjust launch control with the brake pedal. So I set up to like 4700, went out and did a few launches. Oh my god, does the car ever roll out? It feels so good. I did a data log for him in third gear. The car has never felt so good. Like it is beyond what I ever really expected this to be, honestly. Especially on the stock turbo. I cannot fathom what it's gonna be like on an aftermarket turbo. It's gonna be insane. It is gonna be insane. But right now, the car just feels great. It feels awesome. The packs are in. I don't feel a hesitation or anything during startup or, you know, high RPM, like watt pulls or anything. So I'm gonna go with there was more than likely a slight issue with the coil pack, or at least one of the coil packs, and swapping them out definitely made things. But like right now, the car feels a lot smoother. Like the, whatchamacallit, the vacuum level isn't jumping around as much. The idle's more stable, I guess it seems like. Or maybe, I don't know. I don't really pay attention to it all that much while I'm idling, but it definitely seems, it's usually jumping between like 17 and 18 a bunch, and then now right now it's staying in the 18. It's not jumping out of negative 18. So that's what's up. That's about all I got. I'll have Jesse come out with me tomorrow or somebody, and I'll record some launches for you guys. Give this video a little extra spice. So for you it's gonna be like 2 seconds, but yeah, tomorrow. I decided to go out here on the back roads and do a couple test launches for you guys. I'm gonna slip the clutch quite a bit, see how she feels. The roads are a little wet. I can see this big ass cloud of gross that just rolled in, so I don't know. These guys are staring at me like I'm crazy. I saw, dude. These guys want to show. It's just crazy. They all like ran over here. What up, dudes? You want to see a pull? Sweet. How's that for a pull, huh? You guys like that shit? I thought it was okay. We'll do another one.
I know these aren't the best launches in the world, but as you can see, the type of asphalt I'm working with here, it's a little weird with the clutch pedal and slipping it on this kind of shit. It's like half wet, half not, but
there's a couple of them. Car feels really, really good. I feel like on a nice, flat, good paved street, it would definitely hook a little bit better, book a little bit better. It's about time for some new tires. Maybe we got one more event, one more autocross event, maybe two if I'm lucky on these. We got autocross next Sunday. I'm excited. The car needs washed really, really bad. But this on and off rain, it makes it so hard, like it's pointless to do it. Now hopefully sometime this week I can get in and get a good wash. These guys have been a nice crowd for me today. They were egging me on, telling me to do more pulls, so. I'm gonna go home now. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. My thoughts on the RS7 or the RS3 plugs. If you have plugs that are old, like 40, 50, 60,000, maybe spend the money to upgrade. If you're having a misfire, go ahead, buy those with a new set of spark plugs. It should fix you up. I mean, these are definitely an upgrade for me, but like mine were old. So I feel like that's why the car's running a bit smoother, but it's not gonna unlock any like horsepower or whole bunch of torque or something, but definitely smoothed out the RPMs on Watt. So that's about as much as I can say about those. If you got any questions about them or whatever, feel free to ask down in the comments below. Make sure you drop a thumbs up. I'll leave a link to Shop Dap where I bought these, and that's all I got. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you on the flip-flop.